Welcome to a show about things you can see without going far, and a lot of them are free. If you thought there was nothing in the old heartland, you ought to hit the black op with these fools in a van. Look out, they're driving hard, checking out art in their own backyard. Randy does the steering so he won't hurl. Mike's got the map, such a man of the world. That's Don with the camera, kinda heavy on his shoulder. And that giant ball of tape, it's a world record holder. Look out, they're driving hard, checking out art in their own backyard. Look out, they're driving hard, checking out the world in their own backyard. Checking out the world in their own backyard.
Pretty, it's like the Grand Canyon over there.
Dear TV mailbag, did we forget Winona? Hi, Don the Camera Guy here, veering off old 66 for just a bit to soak up the red rock splendor outside Sedona. We, as always, being two TV weasels up front, with me and the world's largest ball of videotape filling up the space that is left. As you can see, we're rolling right through Sedona, and with JD from Blue Feather Tours leading the way, heading on to Cornville. Now McMansions may be popping up on the hills out here, but the sight we seek is down in the valley and far more unique. That would be Eliphante, a complex art compound that Michael and Lita Khan began to build in the 1970s. Michael passed away mere months before, but his widow has graciously agreed to share with us the fruits of their labors.
Yeah, we lived in Provincetown, Massachusetts, Cape Cod. A wonderful, wonderful place, and I thought this could never possibly be as wonderful a place. But this is pretty wonderful, but in a totally different way. We had a leaky tent at first, and we had an old truck that also leaked. So because we just had two leaky structures to live in, and winter was coming, and we knew that wouldn't work, we started to build Eliphante, which wasn't Eliphante when we started.
Oh, look there.
It was just Mike and I. We didn't know anybody in the area. We were brand new to Arizona. Well, we'd lived 2 years in Sedona, but that's a different life in Sedona than out here in Cornville. And we just started digging in the hillside, thinking we'd make ourselves a shelter for the winter. And pretty soon we realized it was turning into an art form and it wouldn't be shelter for the winter. So we built that little shack over there that's called the Winter Palace. And it took 5 years to complete Eliphante. And I don't know if it looks like an elephant to you or not, but the couple who owned the land, they came down one day and we were just constructing this entranceway. And he says, aha, Eliphante. And so the name stuck. Do you want to come in, Eliphante?
Sure, love to.
Who first?
You.
We'll follow you.
Everything you see, Michael made, except the piano, of course. Mike would sit up till midnight or 2 a.m, hand carving those pieces that look like bones. He was just playing with what materials came his way, and finding out how they could move and work the same he did with paints and what colors work together. And as you can see, all colors work together. There are no colors that don't work together.
They teach that in art school.
I'm sure they do.
The rock, I assume, all came from right here in the creek and just carrying it
up. The rocks came from the creek, from the hillside, and from a dry wash, which is a good half mile away. 2 or 3 rocks on your back in a burlap sack. I mean, you know.
How about the sculptures as we pass by some of these? Are they just, you know?
Constructions by Michael. Yeah, isn't that a beauty?
I gotta ask, hippodome.
Well, just like Eliphante sort of looked like an elephant to somebody, as you approach this structure, it sort of looks like a hippopotamus, sort of. After we moved out of the Winter Palace, we built this. I used to weave, and it was going to be a weaving studio, and it was going to have a little low, intimate roof coming off the hillside there. And every time the scaffold kept getting higher and higher and higher because it looked so beautiful. So it is beautiful, but practical it isn't.
Were there ever things you didn't want him to paint? Or was it just, that was the way it was?
No, there's nothing I didn't want him to paint. The floor is painted, the rocks are painted. That look in his eye, when he was painting, that's the way he looked. And actually in this photo, he is painting that back wall. And he's just so happy to be painting. Okay, on to Pipe Dreams. It's called Pipe Dreams because when we started with this hole in the ground, we thought, well, how are we gonna make a ceiling, a roof on this? And people started bringing us pipes, including the main one that's sticking through there. It was like an old well casing. The idea was to create a space big enough so that we could do like a maze. So it's essentially Michael Kahn's works from the 1960s, almost to the present, not quite to the present. The whole structure here is a collaborative effort, but the artwork, the paintings are Michael's. This section you're coming to next is a total collaboration between Michael and Michael Glastonbury, who came and spent time with us. And a lot of this tile work and the floor work is done by Michael Glastonbury.
There are so many nice places to just sit and enjoy.
Exactly. My hope is that these 15 or so major oil paintings will find one home so they can live together forever, either at a wonderful museum or a wonderful library or even a bus station or, you know.
He didn't see it as work, I gather.
He didn't see it as work. That's true. That's very important. It was what he wanted to do. I wish more people could have a life like that. Do what they really want to do. Wouldn't that be great?
I suppose you get this a lot, but Lord of the Rings and the whole sense of the Hobbit village does sort of pop into mind when you first...
Yeah, they got it from us. No, we never saw the movie, we didn't read the books, and you know, but I think those things are just in you, you know, and some people, they have a passageway to come out and express themselves.
Now art isn't all that Eliphante has to offer. There's recreation too. Tennis, anyone? That would be no net tennis, with a minimal set of rules to govern it.
You may not keep score. Don't you dare.
Sweating profusely now, we said our fond farewells to Lita and exited Eliphante. Passing by Cornville once again, through Clarkdale, and if our van will make it, on up to Jerome. That's up in a very real way.
It was a lost town, and the artists and old hippies kind of reclaimed it.
Well, you know, Jerome wasn't built in a day.
Reborn for the tourist trade, the town's claim to fame these days is paranormality. Now ghost chasers we are not, but we're booked for the night in the old Jerome Grand. Once the town's hospital and now a haunted hotel of some repute. So far, nothing spooky to report, but as usual, our world record holder's getting some looks in the lobby.
Now, wait, what's the purpose of this?
Now that's a tough question.
Yeah, you've asked the $1 million question.
Gets a shirt.
It doesn't have a purpose whatsoever.
Well,
Well, take it upstairs. I heard enough about the ball.
Okay.
Looks like the boys have been banished, but there's always the elevator. Going up, fifth floor, ghostly apparitions, unsolved mysteries, and things that go bump in the night.
Hey, we're not looking for no trouble.
Actually, neither are we. after surviving the night with no signs of Casper, we're ready to stop and smell the flowers.
Do you mind?
No.
Wow.
And then wind our way back through the mountains till connecting up with the Mother Road itself. And apparently others are thinking the same. The streets of sleepy little Seligman are teeming with 66 lovers. The snowcap especially is packing them in, so much so that our resident ice creamologist can't hack the wait. So we'll resume the driving portion of this show, driving on to a town whose name did make the song. Right there with Barstow and San Bernardino, I'm talking about Kingman, the home of Andy Devine, a funny voice fixture in old Western movies, but wait, there's more. A whole lot more, as we soon discovered when we stopped to play catch with a cavalcade of classic cars cruising by.
Over the Beale Monument.
Aren't those camels?
They are.
Just so we get our facts straight, it's Lieutenant Edward Fitzgerald Beale commanded an exploration of wagon route to the Colorado River with the only camel train in American history.
Okay, fly ball, over the camels. Oh yeah.
Tell us about some of the excellent movies that this guy Devine was in.
Well, you know, I'm not sure he was in any excellent movies.
Come tell us about Andy Devine.
We know he was a movie star.
Did you know that?
Yes.
We're telling you. So far,
you guys know more than us, and we've lived here all our lives.
Now that's something we seldom hear. And having heard it, you'd think we might ride off into the sunset. But as you can see, old Saul still beating down brightly as we depart Kingman. Next up, Chloride, a town whose name is ripped straight from the periodic table. Small in population, but big in reputation for its appreciation of recycled art. The biggest concentration of which appears to be here along Payroll Avenue, at the home of Shady Ladies, AKA Sharon Giddings, a Cali transplant who has become, and I'm using her words here, a true Chloridian.
I know some people in this town probably think I'm a little crazy because I got some stuff here. People usually get rid of rocks, but I bring them here, you know.
I really like the bottle tree.
This was my original one over here. And I figured this is better than any sign, because people, if I had a penny for each picture, I would be rich. But that's just a joke, you know.
Okay.
I love crystals. I do, I'm just starting this. This is crystals. I do a lot of kayaking down the river. And so these are rocks I get down at the river. And then these are the old purple glass. I'm the only person in Chloride that has a running spring year round. Here's my running springs.
Why?
And that's my wishing well.
I see the wishing well right there.
And then I have here is called Music Rocks or a Girl Rock Concert. And then there's my big wind chime. The big gear is off a real old cement truck.
Now, is this how you get all your rocks back? You haul them back with this?
Or? I only drove it a couple times and I won't do it again.
Why not?
Because I'm not a tractor girl. I have two kayaks, so I pull one and I fill it up with rocks and sticks. All this stuff I brought back, because I love it.
Do you call this stuff something? Is there a term?
It's yard art.
It's
yard art. And this rock is named, this rock is a very special rock because it's a Leverite. Leave it right there. This I call my bell rock. This is called Twister Alley.
Is that like Kirstie Alley?
Twister.
Oh.
I make barbed wire wreaths, mobiles, wind chimes. I do paintings and I do mostly the barbed wire, and I do stained glass.
You're a Renaissance beach girl.
Yeah, I have to change hats a lot, but that's why I don't never really wear a hat. I got mad, so I took my stove out of the house because I didn't want any more, so I got no stove in there. I don't need a stove.
No, not eating anymore?
I eat healthy food. But anyway, do you want to just come in here real quick?
Let's go see.
Just a minute. I have to move, Kathy. I had everything inside, outside. Let me just wait. You gotta walk.
Sharon, is it safe to come in?
Yes.
Okay, here we come.
This used to be my house. This used to be my living room. Since I moved my three shops into three rooms, this is what it looks like, a rat maze. You have to go around and try to find a way out. To me, I always say it's not really a house. This is more of a hobby.
You got everything. What don't you have?
Time. I need more time.
You tried the spice cabinet?
Oh. You're full of ham too, aren't you?
Well, tofu maybe, and come to think of it, hunger is starting to set in. But before we go, I just gotta ask what she know about Andy Devine.
I guess he was a famous person that maybe, I don't know, I should know, but I don't know, I'm sorry. I don't study Kingman, only Chloride. I can only do one town at a time.
Put me to shame, give that thing a hoist.
We left Sharon with a big ball experience, which she warmed too well, and set off with one last scenic twilight view in mind. Hoover, it's not just a vacuum anymore. Sin City, here we come. Doubt about it, Fleeny would approve. We're rocking out with the doom coughs in a Vegas casino, and the good news is, so far no one's gotten hitched or lost their shirt. But the reason we're here is the man up there with the accordion, Dr. Lonnie Hammargren, the former lieutenant governor of the great state of Nevada. He's also a noted neurosurgeon whose pals and patients include astronauts and entertainers, boxers, and guys named Knievel. Lonnie loves history, local, national, interstellar. Most of all, he loves picking up pieces of the past and hauling them home. Though it's meant expanding that home exponentially to accommodate it all.
This is not my creation. This is a replica of the Palace of the Governor. Some of these buildings are what I put together as a modern Mayan museum.
It's like a journey around the world in one city block. Better buckle up. Dr. Lonnie's ready to roll.
Have you seen the brightest burning up and down Las Vegas Strip?
When I got the staircase, it was a little too big for my house, so I cut a hole in the garage and extended it out there.
I've seen the lights on Broadway, San Francisco by the Bay.
And I've got other Liberace pianos.
Fascinating babies hanging around. Nina Prima singing, the Louis Prima sound of Lord.
But the prime thing I had was Liberace's desk. It's 14 feet long. And I use it in my lieutenant governor's office in Carson City.
Nothing can compare with my home Las Vegas, USA.
The past, that
past,
way?
Past. Uh-huh. And this is a model of my grandpa's bar in Sunrise, Minnesota, population 15. And these are Liberace stools. This is a cathedral that I built. Now, why did I start? Well, when you get a cathedral roof like this up here, you can't just toss that on top of an ordinary room. And this is a early 1800s Venetian gondola. I didn't realize how rare it was at the time. Come on out here. This is a phony rail car, except the wheels are Howard Hughes's rail car. The MGM Grand had a railroad, and they had a whole bunch of things with the lion. These are off the Boardwalk Casino, but this is a fabulous thing. I bought in a canister. It was an engine inside for the Spruce Goose. We're talking 28 cylinder.
What kind of mileage did it get?
pretty low. Now I have shows here. The showboat is torn down now, but that was the valet booth there. And here is the unbelievable part, guys. I have acquired the paddle wheel from the original showboat built in the 50s. And this over here is Liberace's Easter egg.
Liberace's
Easter egg. Yeah, lift up the sign there. Egg for Easter, that's good. This is a 144th scale model of the International Space Station. And then the big one up here is 3/8 of the actual size of the International Space Station.
Now, are we in the Fremont Street Experience?
This is the Fremont Street Experience. It's the cowboy downtown.
There's a lot of stuff up here.
Oh, there's a lot of stuff. But you ain't seen nothing yet. See, this little crane I made is a model of the Stratosphere Tower, which is downtown.
Sure.
And if you look at the top of this Stratosphere Tower, there's a little roller coaster there. Well, that's the little roller coaster that used to be up there. So when I heard they were taking it down, I had to have it. These here are from a movie I was in.
Pyramid?
Oh, the pyramid.
Yeah, it's right in front of me. I gotta ask.
You gotta ask. If you go around it 1 million times, you've gone from the North Pole to the South Pole. It also has a telescope, a big one in there. And I built this pyramid here before they built the Luxor. Many of the things I've anticipated the cultures of the world that will be represented on the strip.
Whoa, watch that, Donnie.
All these are pieces and parts and motorcycles, some of them mine. But this is Robbie Knievel's. These are two different crashes that he was in. Anyway, all this is stuff of things that I've had of circus stuff and toys, 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 and toys. I acquired a lot of Johnny Weissmuller's collections, including his jock straps and others, and you'll see those in a minute. But
I'm looking forward to that.
Are you just a guy who's always looking?
Always looking. But I don't have an agenda. And people keep calling me to buy all kinds of weird stuff. They want big money for it. I don't pay much for anything. That was John Lennon's Bentley. And it was all, I had two of them. I had the original and a replica. But I have the world's largest collection of Tijuana space art.
I've never heard that called Tijuana space art.
Well, I made it up. This is the original basket from the movie Around the World in 80 Days. And there's my Cleopatra there. Inside that is this three-wheeler. And it was licensed to Evel Knievel. I got it, acquired it, and repainted it. So it's the world's only bicentennial Messerschmitt.
Well, where's the tomb?
Oh, a tomb.
Tomb.
Iron lung from polio in the 50s. And I bought this out at the swap meet. And I've been an Egyptologist for a long time. And I made the casket to fit the Messerschmitt. And then I moved the Messerschmitt out for this because that's where I'm going to be pickled. And I'm going to be pickled in vodka, Swedish vodka. I'm making history. By collecting it, I'm making history. That wasn't my initial goal, but I just loved all the toys and the stuff. I've had up to 10,000 people here on a weekend. They line up around the blocks and wait standing for hours to go through just to see the stuff.
Does that make you feel good?
Yeah. Come on, I'm egocentric and it's my toys and collections. I want to show them off.
And what a show it's been. Though I'm pretty certain we missed whole sections of the house and never did see Tarzan's jock. Oh well, reason to return. That and the doom coughs, of course. From the dance floor, this is Don the Camera Guy, signing off.
DVDs, T-shirts, and a companion book for this series are available by calling 1-800-459-9733. To learn more about the sites and artists featured on this episode, and to get more information about the show, go to rarevisionsroadtrip.com.
Oh, the strokes!
Here's our chance to get rid of that extra baggage we...
Look at that. I won't even show the viewers the price you paid.
Nobody could ever say this show doesn't help people. Seriously, we help them.
Look, there they go. Their life has been changed.
They're better off.
They're better off. They're going
to Bullhead City.